Two new surveys from the American Academy of Dermatology show a troubling trend. Young adults are slacking on sun safety. 28% of 18 to 26-year-olds say they don't believe suntans cause skin cancer. And 40% say they only wore sunscreen when others nagged them about it. And 14% said wearing sunscreen was more harmful than direct sun exposure. Experts say Gen Z is more susceptible to misinformation about sunscreen and skin cancer because of social media platforms like TikTok.
Dr. Ida Arango is a chair of the Department of Dermatology at Baylor Medicine, and she joins us live this morning. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
When you look at the statistics, it's pretty troubling. And how do you fight this battle when you have, they're called influencers for a reason, I suppose. So how do you fight that battle, particularly with Gen Z?
Well, I think it's just giving them the correct information with science that backs it. And, you know, sometimes you have to also go, you know, present things to them the way that they see it and make it. A lot of times with young people, I won't tell them it'll prevent skin cancer, but I'll tell them it'll prevent aging and wrinkles.
Yeah.
And wrinkles. And that's usually what convinces them to wear their sunscreen then.
Well, and so another myth is drinking water hydrates you enough that it prevents sunburn. We can assume that that is false, correct?
There's no science to back that up. There are a lot of good things for hydration, but that's not one of them.
And one of the things, though, that people hear is that sunscreens have a chemical that can cause cancer. Can you talk about that, what chemicals may or may not be good for us in sunscreen?
Well, basically, you can divide sunscreens into two categories, the physical blockers, which have zinc and titanium. And those are really the sunscreens are the best for people who are worried about chemicals or have sensitive skin. And then there are the other sunscreens that are called chemical blockers because they absorb the light and they are more invisible. And so people like to use those more. At very, very high doses, there could be some issues with those chemicals, especially an allergic reaction to them. But they don't cause cancer. And there's never been any studies to show that they actually cause cancer. It's a theoretical thought.
We also have seen some stuff on Instagram that say, oh, well, you need some vitamin D, especially if you live in Chicago or in the Midwest where you don't get a lot of vitamin D absorption. I mean, that's something you could take in a supplement, right? If you don't necessarily need to go out in the sun without any sunscreen.
That's true. You can take it in a supplement, or if you want to get it from the sun, all you need is about 10 or 15 minutes of sun exposure three times a week. So it's not something that you need to be out and get a sunburn. The sunburn is what we're trying to avoid. And the prolonged exposure to getting the really deep tans, those are the ones that you want to avoid because those are the ones that cause the skin cancers.
And is there a point with the SPF where it doesn't do you any more good? What's the max there, 35? Is it 50?
30 is what we usually recommend. Use at least an SPF of 30 because no one ever puts it on correctly. You want to make sure that you get at least a teaspoon of it up for your face and about a shot glass for your body. No one ever puts that much on. So. We recommend that if you do an SPF of 30, you're getting an SPF of 15, which is what we normally would recommend.
Hmm. How worried are you about the rates of melanoma? You know, when we look at people saying, oh, you know, sunscreen causes cancer. I'm not going to wear sunscreen. I want a base tan. I'm going to tanning beds. How concerned are you about that?
Well, you know, it's one of the fastest growing cancers in humans right now, and it's deadly. And it doesn't need to be gigantic. And, you know, sometimes people come in with a very small, like the size of a pea, melanoma, and it's already spread to their lungs or to their brain. So because it's a deadly skin cancer and it doesn't have any symptoms, it's one of those things that you want to prevent from happening, especially if you have a family history of melanoma. So I think it's very critical that you need to protect yourself. And sunscreen is not the only way to protect yourself. You know, avoidance of the sun, protective clothing, et cetera, all different ways that we can help not get as much sun exposure.
All right, doctor, thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Thank you.